Hello everyone, once again welcome to my YouTube channel, and today I'm going to show you how you can upload files, how you can transfer files from PC to the web server of your website using FileZilla software. This is the link for FileZilla. If you want to download this, I'm going to leave this link in the description of this video, and here you have to download this one, FileZilla Client. Download this, install this, and when you will open it, you will get an interface like this. This is FileZilla software. Here you have to click on this icon just below file menu. Click on this, you will get site manager window like this. Here you have to click on new site. You will get option to name this. Name it whatsoever you want to. Press enter key. Here you have to enter host name. Make sure you have selected this. You can create multiple sites here. So select this. Click here and enter the domain name to which you want to have a connection like this. You can also enter FTP account here. Then you have to select file transfer protocol inside this protocol option. Encryption you have to select only use plain FTP. You can also leave it as it is, but I'm going to show you in a while that how you have to use these options. So stay with me till the end of this video. Logon type you have to select normal. Select only use plain FTP. And here you have to enter username and password. So if you are using your domain name here, your website's domain name here, then you can use cPanel's username and password. Both of these information is provided by web hosting service provider. So make sure you get these credentials and then enter these here like this. And then you have to click on OK so that all these settings get saved inside this demo site. So click OK. Now when you will click on this small arrow icon, then FileZilla is going to list all the sites you have saved inside this software. So we have just only created one site here. So click on this and FileZilla will try to connect. And let's see that whether we connect or not. Here you can see directory listing successful. And if you will see on the right hand side under remote site, then you can see all these directories on my web server. When you will click any of these, then you will be able to see inside of this directory under this like this. Go to public HTML. Where we used to upload our website files which are available publicly. This is the folder public HTML. Here you can see all these files just below it. Okay, and on the left hand side, this is our computer directory desktop. And if you want to access my computer, then here it is. So let me show you how you have to upload. Now basically what you have to do, first of all you have to choose the file which you want to upload. Like I want to upload an image file from desktop, and here it is, image file capture png, and I want to upload inside a new directory. So how can I create a new directory? Just simply right click anywhere inside this box, create directory, choose this, name it whatsoever you want to name it, demo folder. Demo folder, click on OK. Here you can see this is created, and after creating this directory, if you cannot see this, you can also click here. This is going to refresh all these folders. So I want to put this image file inside this directory. So double click on it so that you can get inside this directory and simply click and drag. Okay, this way you can transfer files, and here just at the end you can see successful transfers, failed transfers and queue files. Okay, you can also select multiple files and you can click and drag, and all these files are going to be uploaded to your web server. So this way you can transfer files. Now let's say you want to change the permissions of any of given file or any of the folder, then you have to right click on that particular folder, then you have to choose file permissions, and you can easily change permissions of any file available on web server. Let's say you want to delete this, you can select by clicking on it and you can press delete, or you can right click and select delete. And if you want to also delete the parent folder, parent directory, then select it from here. It's in public HTML demo folder, and then delete it. So this is the way you can transfer files, you can delete files, you can update files. And let me show you how you can update files. Like, let's say this is a text file, right click on this and click on view and edit, and you will choose this option. Then FileZilla is going to provide you option like this, and basically you have to also choose the default editor, and then you will get this option. I'm not using this for the first time, but when you will use FileZilla first time and you will try to edit any file, then this is going to confirm that whether you want to use default text editor or not. Here you can edit whatsoever you want to, and then you can click on save, and this is going to save on your web server. Okay, you can also download files from web server, simply click and drag to this site. Okay, so this way you can use this software. Now many times you may get an error like 20 seconds of inactivity. You are disconnected due to 20 seconds of inactivity. In that case, what you have to do, click on edit, go to settings, and under this tab connection on the right hand side, you have to increase this value, timeout in seconds. You will get 20 here by default. So enter 100 and click on OK to save this. If still you get error, then choose the site by clicking on the site manager icon. Click site which is giving you error, and here on the right hand side go to transfer settings, choose passive, come back here, click on connect. If it gets connected, open it once again and go to transfer settings, passive, click on OK to save these settings. And if still FileZilla doesn't allow you to connect, then come back to general, and you have to choose between these options one by one and try to find out that which option works for you. Okay, so this way you can connect to the web server using FileZilla. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share and comment if you get any error. See you in next video.